it's high time I brought you here on the crossroads.
Yeah, I agree with you.
I do see the crossroads as being a bit of an initiative ceremony, a test of nerve, perhaps.
Yeah, you're right. It's
yes,
just
you're
that...
bound to feel a little nervous, Jeanette. A few butterflies in the stomach, tight whitening of the knuckles. But once you've done the crossroads as many times as I have, you learn to whistle at fear and snap your fingers at terror.
Yeah, but while you're whistling at fear and snapping your fingers at terror, I'm going to introduce the show now. Welcome to Alton Towers for another edition of Hold Tight. Well, this week's the show we've got Stephen Tinty Duffin and a new little gentleman to Bob.
Plus, of course, our two score team is going for goal and our 40-foot high spikes and ladders quiz board.
He's still whistling up here and stabbing your fingers at terror, Bob.
Worked before. Anyway, never mind. Let's be today's two teams whose eyes are skyward for that winning square on the giant snakes and ladders board. And they are from Malbank County High School, Nantwich in Cheshire, David Hannigan. Yeah. Elizabeth Richards. Yeah. Paul Griffiths. Yeah. And their scoreboard runner, a man who's just given me 4 out of 10 for my script, English teacher Mr. Cook. Yeah. And their worthy opponents from Albury Wells School, Bridge North in Shropshire, Anthony Cook. Yeah! Alison Graham. Yeah! Terrace Mays. Yeah! And their scoreboard runner, or in this case, scoreboard jogger, PE teacher Mrs. Brown.
Yeah! And while Bob's team's straining their brains, my two teams will be bending their backs in today's race. From Malbank County in Antwich, we have Peter Alexander and Christina G. Yeah! And from Albury Wells Northbridge, we have Suzanne Payne and Neil Cornwell. Yeah!
Thanks, Jeanette. We'll be seeing your teams in action very shortly. But for now, fasten your seatbelts for round one of our quiz. Teams, are you ready? First question. How many minutes are there in 1/10 of an hour? First back is Nantwich. There are 6 minutes in 1/10 of an hour. Move on to... What's the first letter of the university that won the 1985 boat race? Bridge North, no. O for Oxford. What is the last vowel to appear in the English alphabet? Nantwich again, it is you. The others are A, E, I, O. And they put you on a ladder square and a ladder question for you. What special training is given at the Bolshoi School in Moscow?
Ballet.
Ballet's right, up the ladder. What colour beauty appeared in an equestrian book written by Anna Sewell? Bridge North, Black Beauty. What is the first letter of the first name of the bear who's a friend of Eeyore and Piglet? Bridge North have it. Winnie the Pooh, move on. And that puts you on the ladder square. Ladder question for you. A doyen de commis is a kind of what?
Pass.
Well, you were close. It's a pear. Stay where you are. And that means it's the end of the first round of the quiz. We have Nantwich ahead on square 6. Bridge North need to catch up. They are on square 3. And now we've got some heavy metal for you. Not this sort of heavy metal. This is a great band with their brand new single. This is To Brook with a single called Falling.
Steve!
there with Snake as their lead singer. We're doing a bit of snaking ourselves with these hula hoops. Last year on Hold Tight, we had Chico Johnson, the world hula hoop champion. Since then, hula hooping has become a sport with properly organised events and championships. Demonstrating today, we've got the 1984 British hula hoop champion, Stephen Parks, who unbelievably only started hula hooping last year while sitting in our audience watching Chico Johnson. So it just shows what he can do in 12 months. And next to me here going completely crazy is the female world champion, who is Melody Howes. Stop for a minute, Melody. That's brilliant. Melody, it's difficult to imagine hula hooping as a sport, but how does one person get judged against another? What makes one better than another?
Well, we judge people on three categories: difficulty, control, and showmanship. And so the best hula hoopers are the ones who do the most difficult moves with the most style, with the most control.
But, I mean, what Stephen's doing there, he's actually got three hoops going in a different part of his body.
That's right. Difficulty includes being able to twirl hoops around different parts of your body, which is what he's doing now, and being able to move them up and down fairly smoothly, which is what he's doing. In fact, he's picking up one from the ground. And
it's incredible.
While keeping the other ones going.
Well, I've discovered that I am to hula hooping. Could you take that? What a brick is to flying. Now, could you give me a few tips? I mean, well, now you see, it keeps going.
Are you right-handed?
Well, I do things if I'm right. Yeah.
Okay, push the hoop to the left.
The left.
That's right, and you're gonna, no, to the other left.
Hang on, we'll get this.
You got
Melody.
It now.
I'm there, that's brilliant.
You got it.
Well, I've got the hoop, and Jeanette's got a length of rope.
Well, I wouldn't give up your day job if I was you, Bob. Now it's time for today's race, which takes the form of a tug of war. Each team is in a boat, and the boats are joined by this stout rope. The object of the game is for them to try and get this central float past the end of their pole. Our two resident frogmen are here, Ambrose and Emile, to make sure that everything goes safely. Now it's the best of three, and the winner will get three squares on the hold tight board. Are you ready? Hold tight!
And Suzanne and Neil from the yellow team, Bridge North, get off to a powerful start, which puts Peter and Christina from the blue team, Nantwich, at an immediate disadvantage. Like dryland tug of war, this game calls more for tactics than strength. Ask any crocodile. With the cheers of their supporters echoing across the water, the yellow team, Bridge North, really digs in, maximising their advantage. There is really nothing that Nantwich can do apart from trying to delay the moment of defeat. Bridge North are roaring home, dragging Nantwich slowly but surely backwards through the water. Round one goes to Bridge North.
Are you ready? Hold tight!
And once again in round two, Bridge North use the same aggressive tactics. Nantwich, their momentum lost, have to resign themselves once again to that long, slow backward drag as Bridge North, scenting victory, step up the paddle rate. Even the cheers of the supporters can do nothing to prevent the inevitable, as Nantwich, beaten more by tactics than strength, surrender the match to the powerhouse paddlers of Bridge North.
And the winners are Bridge North, the yellow team, and they get three squares on the hold tight board!
Which puts everything all square on square six. Right, well, they're paddling in the puddle. We'll carry on with the quiz, and it's round two of the quiz, the anagram part. Teams, are you ready? A three-letter word, first of all, for a rank in judo or a comic character who's desperate. First team to spell it out is Nantwich, desperate band. Head through the snake, a snake square question for you. Who is called the Rochdale Cowboy?
Mike Harding.
Mike Harding's right. Move on one. Yay! Add a letter for what you do when you repair holes in socks. Nantwich again. New darn socks. Rearrange those letters for the currency of South Africa. Nantwich have it. It is the Rand. Add a letter for half of the name of Simon Le Bon's group. Nantwich are doing well. It is Duran Duran. Move on one.
add a letter for what a book is when it hasn't been looked at. Nantwich again, it's unread. And that means it's the end of the anagram part of the quiz. Let's see the scores. Well, Nantwich have gone a long way ahead there on square 12. Bridge North need to catch up still, square 6. And now welcome Stephen Tintin Duffy singing Unkiss That Kiss. Stephen Tinter, did you enjoy that?
I did.
It was excellent. Where are we up to on the quiz? Let me see. We've got Nantwich on square 12, Bridge North, they need to catch up still, they're on square 6. Yeah! You've got the questions there for round 3, I'll go and mark the teacher's homework. Okay, here we go.
What's the first letter of the smallest and coldest planet in our solar system? Nantwich first with P for Pluto!
Yeah! Which puts you on a ladder square? Ladder question for you. If you go abseiling, what do you do?
Swinging down rocks on a rope.
That's near enough. Yes, down a rough face on a rope. Put the ladder above!
What's the first letter of the surname of the singer of Thriller? Bridgewater first, with J for Michael Jackson.
Which puts you on a snake square and a snake question for you. A group of what would be called a coven?
A coven? Witches.
Witches is right! Hey. Move over here!
According to Frankie, how many tribes went to war? Nantwich first with two!
Just a minute!
What colour coats did British soldiers wear in the 18th century? Britain first with red! What is the first letter of the surname of the brothers Groucho, Chico and Harpo? Bridge North again with M for the Marx Brothers. That's the end of the round, so the winners are Nantwich. So it's congratulations to Malbank County High School, Nantwich.
Yay!
And thanks to their noble opponents, Aubrey Wells School, Bridge North.
Yay!
And they all receive one of these wonderful Hold Tight badges.
Yay!
And it's also thanks to our special guests, who were to Brook, Stephen Tintin Duffy, the fabulous hula hoopers, and wishing them all success in the final on Sunday.
Yay!
On next week's show, we've got Simply Red and a very old friend of mine, and Queen of Connections, Sue Robbie.
Yay!
Plus, of course, our two school teams. So until then,
hold tight!
Yeah! And this time, the ancient texts are being given a 1987 treatment. Alistair MacDonald went along to